I think one of the highlights of that story was definitely you in Montreal having that title match. And I just wonder, you know, because you're an honest guy who's very introspective. And I wonder, you know, because you're a guy who likes to paint your story and tell your, you know, do the things that you like to do, like you said, give everybody everything that they want out of wrestling. When you have a loss like that, is it hard to take? Like, is it hard to deal with afterwards, or is that just part of the business?
No, it was a little hard, you know, if you want the truth. It was a little hard because, you know, like, and I don't think I'm being controversial in saying this, but I'm not the chosen guy, you know, obviously. Like, I've been handed a lot of opportunities, and I've delivered on a lot of those opportunities throughout my time in the company. And I'm grateful for all of it. But clearly, I mean, I don't think anyone would say, like, oh, clearly he was being positioned to be the top guy or to, you know, be the most popular guy in the show.
Yep.
Obviously, that's not the case. And that's fine. But I guess in the back of your head, you're always banking on your ability to get there. And somehow or another, you just feel like you'll get there. And then it is hard to get there. It's almost miraculous to get there, or to get one of these organic runs that the audience sort of wills into existence. And you could probably count them on one hand in the last 10 years with Daniel Bryan, Becky Lynch, Kofi Kingston,
maybe like
and myself,
CM Punk and you.
And yeah. Who knows what's happening with LA Knight? I feel like he's starting to get a little bit of that right now at the moment, and good for him. But all this to say, it's like a lightning in the bottle type of a thing. You don't get it very often. And then you kind of get it and you're like, well, you almost feel like the story, the audience, your performance, all of it has like almost, it's just got you to the exact right place that you dreamed you'd be. And then when you get there, it's like, it just kind of falls short and you don't know if you'll ever get it back. You know what I mean?
Yep.
So for sure that's hard, and you don't know if you can do it again. And like I said, it's only happened a handful of times in the last 10 years. So I still think the investment, and the equity that I have with the audience from that storyline, I think I've penetrated a lot of hearts to where I'll stick around there for a while, because I've made them feel all these feelings that I was just talking about a moment ago. Yep. I took them on that ride. And when somebody takes you on that ride and they penetrate your heart, they're in there. And they got to do a lot to get out of there, you know? So now you're probably going to cheer them for years to come. So I got a lot out of that story. Don't get me wrong. That goes without saying. So if and when I do get to that mountaintop again, or I get in the title picture, or and I'm the big challenger trying to, you know, fulfill my destiny or whatever it is, it might still get there, but it'll just have a different feel. It'll still be part of the overarching story of the character. But it just felt like one of those things like, man, I forced their hand as much as humanly possible, but still just a buck short, you know? And it just, you know, it was a hard pill to swallow.